This is the Music History Today podcast for June 23rd. On today's show, Aretha records, Chubby gets arrested, and Tiffany hits the mall. First up, though, on this date in 1959, Eddie Cochran recorded the song Something Else. In 1960, Paul Anka became the youngest performer at the age of 20 to perform at New York City's famed Copacabana nightclub. In 1965, the Kinks did a gig in Springfield, Illinois that was put together by John Wayne Gacy, who later became a serial killer. Pretty sure the one didn't actually have to do with the other. At least I think not. In 1967, Aretha Franklin recorded the classic Chain of Fools. Also on that same day, John Entwistle of The Who married his wife Allison Wise. In 1970, famed twist singer Chubby Checker was arrested for possession of marijuana. In 1972, Smokey Robinson performed with the Miracles for the final time until the Motown 25 TV special in the mid-1980s. In 1975, Alice Cooper fell from a stage and broke six ribs during his concert in Vancouver, Canada. In 1976, Paul McCartney finished his Wings Over America tour. In 1987, the original social media campaign started when singer Tiffany went on tour, performing at shopping malls in order to promote her album, which had crashed and burned upon entry. The promotional tour worked. Tiffany became a teen singing sensation after that. In 1991, Weird Al Yankovic started recording his song Babalu Music. In 1995, Oasis headlined England's Glastonbury Music Festival. In 2000, Michael Jackson was sued for $21 million by a promoter due to Jackson canceling two concerts. Also on that same day in 2000, David Bowie headlined England's Glastonbury Music Festival. In 2006, Kevin Richardson left the Backstreet Boys, at least until their reunion a few years ago. In 2010, Gorillaz headlined England's Glastonbury Music Festival. And in 2016, a federal judge in Los Angeles, California, said that Led Zeppelin did not steal parts of the Spirit song Taurus for their song Stairway to Heaven. The verdict was appealed in 2018 until the U.S. Supreme Court finally decided to not hear the case, leaving Led Zeppelin the winners in the year 2020. Also in 2016, singer and actress Mandy Moore divorced singer-songwriter Ryan Adams. Mandy Moore later claimed domestic abuse in the marriage, when that, along with a lot of other accusations from other women, led to Adams disappearing for a while. In 2021, Britney Spears officially requested that a judge end the court-ordered conservatorship that was overseen by her father. And in 2022, Paul Simon performed at the Newport Folk Festival for the very first time. In classical music, in 1902, Florence, Italy unveiled their monument to composer Gioachino Rossini. In theater, in 1962, the musical Subways Are for Sleeping closed on Broadway. In 1973, the musical Sugar closed on Broadway. And in 1994, the musical Copacabana premiered in London, England. In award ceremonies that were held on June 23rd, in 2004, Bob Dylan received an honorary doctorate of music degree from Scotland's University of St. Andrews. Albums that were released on June 23rd include in 1964 when Stevie Wonder released Stevie at the Beach. In 1971, The Byrds released Bird Maniacs. In 1973, Can released Future Days. In 1977, AC/DC released Let There Be Rock. In 1979, ABBA released Voulez-Vous. The Angels released No Exit, and Teddy Pendergrass released Teddy Pendergrass' Greatest Hits. In 1980, Bob Dylan released Saved. Also on that same day, Emotional Rescue was released by the Rolling Stones. In 1981, the Tom Tom Club released their self-titled album. In 1985, Fleetwood Mac released Jumping at Shadows. In 1986, Rod Stewart released Every Beat of My Heart. David Bowie released the soundtrack to Labyrinth, and Peter Cetera released Solitude Solitaire. In 1987, Sammy Hagar released I Never Said Goodbye. In 1992, Carcass released Tools of the Trade. Dr. John released Going Back to New Orleans. Glenn Frey released Strange Weather. The B-52s released Good Stuff. Jimmy Cliff released Breakout. And Elton John released The One. In 1997, Billy Bragg and Wilco released Mermaid Avenue. Sparks released Plagiarism. And Paul Weller released Heavy Soul. In 1998, Linda Ronstadt released We Ran. In 2009, Dinosaur Jr. released Farm. Tonic released A Casual Affair, The Best of Tonic. Cheap Trick released The Latest, and John Mellencamp released Life, Death, Live, and Freedom. In 2014, Peter Gabriel released Back to Front Live in London. And in 2015, the Jerry Garcia Band released on Broadway, Act 1, October 28, 1987. Singles that were released on June 23rd include, in 1959, when Elvis Presley did a twofer, he released My Wish Came True and A Big Hunk of Love. In 1965, The Contours released First, I Look at the Purse, and The Miracles released The Tracks of My Tears. In 1972, Johnny Nash released I Can See Clearly Now, a classic song. In 1975, AC/DC released High Voltage, The Amazing Rhythm Aces released Third Rate Romance, and Elton John released Someone Saved My Life Tonight. In 1978, Eddie Money released Two Tickets to Paradise. In 1979, Donna Summer released Bad Girls. In 1980, Pink Floyd released Comfortably Numb, and the Rolling Stones released their song Emotional Rescue. In 1987, Madonna released Who's That Girl from the soundtrack of the movie Who's That Girl. In 1992, Sting with Eric Clapton released It's Probably Me, which was one of the songs from one of the Lethal Weapon movies. In 1996, Matchbox 20 released Real World. And in 2003, Metallica released Saint Anger. Before we go any further, we'd like to tell you that there is now a Music History in Depth podcast where we go more in depth on a few of the events that happen in music history for that particular week. The Music History in Depth podcast runs every Tuesday on YouTube or wherever you get your podcasts from, as does our Music Halls of Fame podcast, which talks about a member of the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame along with other Music Halls of Fame, museums, and walks of fame. The Music Halls of Fame podcast drops every Thursday and can also be found on YouTube or wherever you get your podcasts. Now, back to this podcast. Artists who were born on June 23rd include the original bassist for The Beatles, Stuart Sutcliffe, drummer Jim McPherson of The Breeders, drummer Steve Shelley of Sonic Youth, guitarist Greg Coe, guitarist Mark Chadwick of The Levellers, guitarist Paul Arthurs of Oasis, jazz artist Milt Hinton, Joey Allen of Warrant, Miles Goodwin of April Wine, Nikki Sullivan of Buddy Holly and the Crickets, rapper Icy Narco, rapper Memphis Bleek, Richard Coles of the Communards, Robert Hunter of the Grateful Dead, Rosetta Hightower of the Orlons, singer Adam Faith, singer Anthony Costa of Blue, singer Chico DeBarge of DeBarge, singer Dana Paola, singer Duffy, singer Glenn Danzig of The Misfits, Sam Hine, and also his own group, Danzig, singer Jason Mraz, singer Jessica Taylor of Liberty X, singer June Carter Cash of The Cash Family, singer K.T. Tunstall, singer Lee John of Imagination, singer Mikey Bustos, and songwriter Eddie Pola. Artists who unfortunately passed away on June 23rd include composer Jean-Claude Trial, who passed away in 1771 at the age of 38. Composer Bendix Zink passed away in 1801 at the age of 58. Composer Otto Karl Kospath passed away in 1817 at the age of 63. Composer Nikolaus Meskel passed away in 1833 at the age of 73. Composer Emil Naumann passed away in 1888 at the age of 60. Composer Francis Brown passed away in 1891 at the age of 73. Composer Joseph Skelly passed away in 1895 at the age of 44. Composer Charles Salomon passed away in 1901 at the age of 87. Composer Thomas H. Rowlandson passed away in 1928 at the age of 84. Composer Armin Nabb passed away in 1951 at the age of 70. Composer Reinhold Glier passed away in 1956 at the age of 81. Composer Jean Gallion passed away in 1959 at the age of 80. Musician Boris Vian passed away in 1959 at the age of 39. Country music singer Elton Britt passed away from heart issues in 1972 at the age of 58. Singer and actress Zara Leander passed away in 1991 at the age of 79. Composer Alan Frank passed away in 1994 at the age of 83. Jack Schroer of the Caledonia Soul Orchestra passed away in 1995 at the age of 51. Pete Quaife of the Kinks passed away in 2010 at the age of 66. Blues singer Bobby Blue Bland, the iconic Bobby Blue Bland, passed away in 2013 at the age of 83. Singer Magali Noel passed away in 2015 at the age of 83. Bluegrass musician Ralph Stanley passed away in 2016 at the age of 89. Songwriter Dave Bartholomew passed away in 2019 at the age of 100. The trumpet player for the Canadian Brass from 2000 to 2003 and the Dallas Symphony from 2006 to 2020. Trumpet player Ryan Anthony passed away from cancer in 2020 at the age of 51. Blues singer-songwriter Ellen McIlwain passed away in 2021 at the age of 75. Entertainer Betta St. John passed away in 2023 at the age of 93. Country music singer and mandolinist Jesse McReynolds passed away in 2023 at the age of 93. And Broadway musical lyricist Sheldon Harnick passed away in 2023 at the age of 99. Next on the Music History Today podcast, it is June 24th, when in 2003, Beyoncé debuts as a solo artist on her sister's birthday.